Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the weekly technical video day. Guys, today is December 31st, around 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. First of all, Happy New Year to everyone, and I hope that next year is going to be even much better for everyone and us. So let's start with the video. We're going to start here with the US dollar index, and as a service, it's our responsibility to remind everyone here that the US dollar is ending a cycle. I've been saying that I'm gonna let you guys know in almost every video, so you guys cannot cut in the wrong side of the market. Now, you guys see the structure we have explaining is a debate if this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as a leading diagonal, or this is A, B, Z, W, S, and what we ended now is A with a B, and then the C to come to 82, 89. That's a debate that nobody knows for sure. Now, at this stage, I would say this. It's most likable right now that at this stage we are in A, B, C, W, S, and then this is either A that we end in with a B and C to come, or the ending diagonal. In other words, it's either one of the two. I'm favoring the, according to the RSI, it looks like it's a double zigzag. So if it's a double zigzag, I would say it's most likable that something like this take place, like A, B, C, W, S, A, B, and C, or the ending diagonal. So no matter what it is, all you need to know, guys, is as follow: that as far as this uptrend channel here hold, you need to favor the upside in the dollar. I know it's exhausted. I know it's almost ready to roll over to the downside, but you cannot deny the trend, and the trend is in place as far as this channel hole. All right, we are very close. We see the structure very mature. We see A, B, C. This is three ways here, three back, and already we have A, B, C, three ways here. So it can be counts completed. Now, we haven't seen five ways from the top to declare the top yet. That's for the US dollar index. If we go to the euro, it's the same dilemma. What do you have on the euro? The proposal the way to end. The proposal the way to end right here. And now the dilemma is if it is completed or not. What we have from the lows this week, last week we say a new low is going to happen. That's exactly what happened. Now, this week we say as follows, that this channel is in place, you need to favor the downside. Now, measures, we are around the 618 or the first leg, very possible. I like 2762. But as far as this channel that's holding since October 27 high, that is being tested several times, is in place, I will have to say you need to favor the downside in this pair. All right? Now, after, we're going to see a recovery at least 500 pips to the upside. That needs to be soared after three ways also. Now, Let's take a look at the euro in the 4 hour, so you guys understand what I mean. You see this world-defined channel here. That's a trend channel, guys, for all you guys right there. That's a trend channel. It was tested here, 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 and it looks like it was ready to be tested also yesterday. Now, as far as that channel to the downside hole, all you guys should be selling three ways on the euro. Now, after that channel is taken, And then you have to wait because there's going to be another degree of consolidation. And then let's say that this is the low and the channel is breaker, then you have to trade your Fibo like this and trying to sell around 134, 135, even 137 area before the downtrend is renewed. So keep that in mind. Do not buy the euro as far as this downtrend channel is in place. Now, going to the 1 hour of the euro, what do we have? It looks like we're gonna be presenting this count. Nothing invalidate the count yet, like we explained several times. The entry right here was possible in 3 weeks, and consequently, you need 3 ways from the top. We got the first one already here. Yesterday we said that the euro is gonna sell about 129, 130 area. That's exactly what it did. Now, you have to be practical here, guys. What do you have from the lows? 3 weeks, no four, no five. The euro find support in yesterday afternoon trading right here. So which scenarios do you can have in the euro? Either 1-2, 1-2, or 1-2, 3-4, and a 5, and complete a leading diagonal with a consequently move down here and test the lows and higher. Euro love the euro love the leading diagonals. Keep that in mind. A lot of volume always create leading diagonals. Or this is B, I'm going lower. Taking a look at the short time frame from the highs. Taking a look at the short time frame from the highs, what you have, I can see 1-2, and then 1-2, 3-4, 5-4, 5. I see an impulse to the downside, to be honest with you. Look, now the RSI is the kind of denied me the impulse move, so that's why I keep the door open to the leading diagonal scenario. The number of wave and in a short time frame, look, there is right here, I believe there is towards 60. There is a bit of divergency here, but I believe that this divergency is more a C-way divergency or a three-way. It looks more like a three-way move. Now, the number of wave from the top goes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is an irregular. This looks like an irregular also. So I'm going to call it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 swing. So in some degrees, it's very possible that this is a double zigzag or this is corrected. If that's the case, the leading diagonal can be in place and then we can have a bottom. Otherwise, another alternative that we can have on the euro is, and I'm getting deep in the euro because I know all you guys love the euro. Another alternative is that from here, we're going to trade here again on Sunday. We're going to consolidate lower. We're going to respect the 129 area, and we're going to go higher in a nest. Now, very simple, guys. A break of 129 should open the door toward another low. A break of 130 without extension made the case for the leading diagonal. How you know it? You press your RSI and you press this channel. If the diagonal is in place, they're gonna trade here and going lower. Should not surpass the channel here. And then the RSI should give you divergency in this high. If that's the way, the euro is a buy here. So nothing else that we can say about that. That's very simple. Is we should know by the middle of next week where we are. Now, let's move on to the S&P. S&P, what we see is as follows. Same scenario, we still see a move to around 1320, 1340 in the S&P, and then very low. believe me when I say very low, I believe that the S&P is going to trade around 450 sometimes next year. Now, from there, how are we going to get here is the question. How do we see it? We see as follow. What is the S&P? There you go. We see as follow. It's either a series of nests from here, which is going to make a flat, or even a triangle can be in place, but higher, guys. That means that risk is going to correct higher very soon. Another chart on the daily that I want to show you is the leading, the Norwegian, no, this is the index, the Norwegian crown, which is very, very similar to the dollar index, like we always say, same scenario, ending a cycle and correcting lower very soon. The euro pound, very interesting, very close to our target, which is, no, this is the euro, I'm sorry, my bad. The euro pound, which should trade around 82.78, this is, you see how the channel was tested here, and expecting another test of the channel to finish the move, and consequently a bounce to the outside in this pair. So keep that in mind, because that's what the charts are calling here. Now, this is another pair that we add to the service, is the Euro Aussie. Look at the Euro Aussie here on the dailies. This pair, it have a long way to go to the downside. Now, it's trusting for the daily triangle. I see this move almost completed in some degrees. It can be either 1-2-1-2, or this pair can take the way of, it can start taking the way of a leading diagonal. Still, I believe, is far away from the target, but this pair should be a good buy sometime next year after the euro found the low. A target can be at 114. That's a very, very low target. Otherwise, we have to wait from 125. 125.19 can be the end of this cycle that is coming from the secondary peak right here. Otherwise, it can be 119 or 114. Let me explain to you guys. This pair, in this low that I create right here, it was exactly when phi equals 1. So that's why I believe that that's why I'm going with a phi equals 1 here also. Now, let me see on the daily, because it's a weekly video. That's what I always go with the daily. Only the euro I can go very deep. This is another pair. The cable is in the same dilemma as the euro. Is maybe, this is something that I want to explain, guys. This was a three-way move. If we're still in the D, this low, which is 152.72, should be broken. Otherwise, we are an E already, and we finish this move higher. So no matter, is the same outcome, which is a set-off. If this D goes right here, then cable is down here, and then cable is going to find a way to the upside, and then cable is going to trade around 162 before lower. Otherwise, I would say that we need, I don't know, I start to favor in the idea that cable is done, to be honest with you guys. Because if it makes another low, we're going to get 5 swings from here. So I start to favor in the idea that cable is done, and that's why we present this scenario. In cable, look, this one is the one that is allowing a new low, this one, but that loan needs to be below 152.70. But this one, and I want you to explain it to you guys, can be when cable is already complete, the B-way, and go higher. The count runs and follow. You see that I put a place A there? That's because if that's the case, let me take that tendency there. That means that cable is done. It looks very important to the ISO 5 three ways from the lows. Now, we need two more highs to complete five, but the count runs as follow: A, B, Z, W, S, A, B, C, W, and then you got S. After S, because this was a three-way, you need three-way, and there is three ways if you want to. It is A, B, C, W, S, A, B, C, W. This is the biggest W, right? And then this W is similar to this W, and then this S is similar to this S. Why you need a Y to complete Y, right? And that being the case, this become B. This become B, and then we got A, B, C, A, B, and five. So there is nothing wrong with this structure. Let me draw it to you. You got A, B, C, A, B. Sorry, my bad. You got A, B, C. You got three ways here. Then you got three ways back. So you got a double zigzag here, a double zigzag here, and then you have a flat here. So it's a three-way corrective structure. So it can be done with this scenario. That's why that's when we show in St. Thursday that say that the only way cable is done if it's Y, which is this one, was a flat. So keep that in mind, because if cable does this, if cable does that, cable is a buy here targeting 162, believe it or not. All right? Keep that in mind, guys. So let's leave it there. See you guys on the seminar on Monday. And I hope everyone have, with your family, a happy New Year. And see you guys on Sunday. Thank you.